Well, the last 5 years have been a period of fascinating growth for the energy sector in Colombia. Our oil production has doubled. Our production of coal has increased from about 45 million tons to nearly 97 this year. So fantastic growth rates for this sector. We expect this to continue in the next 5 years. We now produce 1 million barrels of oil per day. We hope to end the decade with 1.5 million barrels of oil per day. Part of the expansion in Colombia is the result of new players coming into our country. Juniors, as they call them, many of them listed in Canada. So we have companies like Pacific Rubiales, Petro Minerales, Talisman, companies that are growing very fast, mainly because of their operations in Colombia. So we're very happy with the juniors. But we're also making sure that the message is heard by the mayors. And we hope that everyone comes, because this is open to all investors. The share of the energy and mining sector in Colombia's GDP is about 9% today. It was nearly 5% a decade ago. But we don't think this is something be proud of, because we want the entire economy to grow very fast. We're growing very fast, but we want other sectors to grow fast as well. So that's why we don't use this measure as an indication of success. We expect the sector to continue growing at very fast rates in the next few years, double-digit rates, which is faster than the rest of the economy in Colombia. This year, we're promoting what we call the 2012 round, which are about 109 blocks for exploration and production of hydrocarbons. One-third of them are for unconventional hydrocarbons, shale oil, shale gas. We're very optimistic about the interest on the part of the companies that would eventually come and explore unconventional hydrocarbons in Colombia. At the same time, we're now promoting mining in the same way, through competitive processes. Rounds where we promote blocks for mining companies to make proposals in terms of investment and in terms of production. Colombia as a whole has many needs in terms of infrastructure, and that's one of our big challenges. In fact, with the revenues we have from the energy sector, we're providing the funding for infrastructure projects. Now, in terms of the infrastructure that is necessary for the energy sector itself, the projects themselves, mining, oil, are building their own pipelines, their own roads, their own railroads, and their own ports. So the sector is providing its own solutions in terms of infrastructure. We don't depend on the national government to solve these problems. We have two main challenges. The first one has to do with the communities where these projects operate. We need to make sure that the benefits of the energy and mining sector are delivered to these groups of the population. We need to improve their standards of living. And that's a commitment on the part of the government, but on the industry as well. We need to make sure that they invest more heavily on the social dimension so that these sectors of the population enjoy the benefits. The second challenge has to do with the environmental impact of these projects. We need to ensure that we adopt the most strict standards in terms of environmental impact. And we need to make sure that we protect Colombia's biodiversity, which is, you know, something that we feel very proud of, because it's something which Colombia really is an outlier in the world. So we need to preserve that. And we need to make sure that although energy is our best chance to develop now, in a few decades, it's going to be biotechnologies. So we need to make sure that we preserve that, because that's our next stage is the technologies that are based on our biodiversity.